Hey guys, sorry, I had to download some new pictures. What is going on with my iPad? There we go. You plan on playing some Skyrim when you get home, Undisputed? Into the Thieves Guild. That's pretty cool. Well, this is when. How was it? First of all, I ended up finishing this, and this one for Patreon at that convention. Because it was so slow. So, trying to figure out how to make this not so all over the place. Let me see. There we go. That'll probably be better. Thank you. So yeah, it was pretty bad. Gotta love Digimon and anything that crosses over with Digimon. Yeah, this one I had a lot of fun with because I love Eerie. She's so cute, and she fit so well in Kari's original outfit whenever she first showed up when she was a kid. Was extremely slow. The con runners really put some bad energy into it. I mean, I talked about the convention like email they sent everybody, and it just I think that bad energy just really boned everybody. I feel like that con was probably. Oh, it's. That's what's messed up with this. I forgot. No. Just this part. Turn off auto rotate. Okay, that's what was wrong with it. Let me fix this screen now. So yeah, the con was extremely slow. There's hardly any attendees. And I think it was because they really didn't advertise it hardly at all. And like it was on the radio, but I mean, even Undisputed, he's from the area and he didn't even know the con was happening. So that's kind of pretty telling that they didn't do a good job. Like sharing the con. Hey, love. The food should be here in just a little bit. So yeah, and it wasn't even just me that did bad, like pretty much everybody, like we made back table and we made back some profit, but nothing like what I'm used to at conventions in that area or conventions in general nowadays. Because it, and I won't go into numbers or anything, but it's just, I usually do way better at that convention, and it was really sad, honestly. It was really disheartening. And there's another con in that area that's run by somebody, like, different people, but it's run by another one of those cons that we were like, I don't know. It's actually not Meowth. So it's actually Palmon with little cat ears to look like Gigi. So it's Mimi and Palmon as Kiki and Gigi. But yeah. And pretty much the whole weekend, everybody was just complaining about the con for this, that, or the other. There were huge gaps where, like, there were zero attendees in there, and it was just us artists and us vendors just kind of hanging out, and it was very weird. The whole experience is just so strange. Which, like I said, it's super weird for this con, because I normally did super well. I don't know if it was the economy or the con runners just not doing a good job or a combination of both. But if that con ends up surviving until next year, I'm definitely not going to do it again. And I'm pretty sure most of my friends will not be doing it going forward either. And honestly, a lot of that guy's cons and cons in general have kind of flopped this year. But I think part of that has to do with the economy being how it is right now. And of course the con runner is just not doing a good job. Nope. Someone's at our door. So, on the one hand, it was a combination of things, but on the other hand, it felt like the con runners were just kind of biding their time and just kind of giving themselves a reason to not do the con anymore, unfortunately. Which, like, if they didn't want to do the con anymore, they could have just canceled it instead of pulling the crap that they did. It was just, I don't know. We were all super ticked off all weekend and just kind of desperately trying to make the best of a bad situation, but we made it through Saturday and Sunday. I honestly kind of wanted to dip after how bad Saturday was, but we stuck it out through Sunday. And Sunday morning / afternoon got a little bit better. But then once it hit like 2:00, it just died. Like, it was all over from there. I need to find a picture of Kiki. Get away from my email, dude. But yeah, basically every other con that was this past weekend also kind of had a rough turnout for everybody. Oh. Oops, that's when I searched it and I forgot the M or the N or whatever. I mainly just need her hair color, eye color, and Palmon. Save. But it was a very odd weekend, because like there was also Y2K or like Y2Con. In I don't even remember where that one is. It was in Texas. I don't remember exactly what area. And it didn't do well at all. Like there's people were talking about one of the vendors like loudly arguing with the showrunner about how the showrunner apparently like promised upwards of 5K for the con, like as a projection of like foot traffic, and they had maybe 1,000 people there. Still at the beginning of the school year. Honestly, that I kind of thought that, but it really didn't affect us like this like it did last year. Or it didn't affect us last year like it is this year. I don't know. I think it's partially because the economy's in the toilet, but that could just be me. So I'm not exactly sure, but is what it is. I'm hoping that my next con will be better. Oh, thanks, love. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't hear you. I love you too. I'm sorry. Can you shut my door? I love you too. Thank you. Where's my water bottle? Could have swore I was in here. Yeah, I don't know. It might be the school year. Might be economy being in the toilet. Might be con runners. Honestly, who knows? That was my bad. Like, I honestly didn't hear him at first. These headphones are actually pretty good. It's okay. It could be worse, honestly. Like, it's fine. We were honestly just kind of happy to be out of there whenever we were able to leave. So we were just like, all right, let's go. Let's go home. And then yesterday, I was supposed to stream, but I didn't feel super hot. Like, I don't know. I always feel pretty drained after conventions. Which normally it's a lot worse because it was actually busy or whatever, but I don't know. I just wasn't in the mood. But fingers crossed that Fan Festival will be better. I mean, it'll be in a much bigger area, and I don't believe anything else big is the same weekend, so I think it should be okay. So, we'll see. I mean, we also kind of foresaw it being a bit of a shit show, so we were just kind of trying to figure out how bad it truly was going to be. The con blues, I mean, sometimes. If I have, like, a really good time, or, like, I get to see some of my friends that I don't get to see very often, sometimes, but most of the time I'm kind of just ready to be home, because my social battery is dead. Like, after this one, I was just ready to be home. I was over it. Just ready to lay down and watch One Piece. And that was essentially what we did. Watched One Piece on Sunday when I got home, and just kind of hung out and watched One Piece again yesterday. But I did get to see one of my friends that I always see in that area, that we really only get to see each other at conventions. So we got to hang out for a bit, which was nice. And Stace and I went to dinner with a couple of my other artist friends, and we had a nice bitch sesh about the convention. So that was fun. Some sweet girl talk. Talking shit about a convention. The bottom of Mimi's bangs. I know they do like a little curly bit. Oh, I did end up picking up a You liked Mimi better than Sora? I think I liked Mimi better than Sora too. I'm not a huge fan of either of them, but I think I did prefer Mimi. She was just cuter, like a cute aesthetic. But I did pick up an Ace figure from the con, I hardly ever see Ace stuff, so I was like, yes, please. I now have him on my desk. He's probably like 8 inches tall. They had one of the ramen topper ones too, so like my deciding factor between the standing figure and the ramen topper, it was the price. And the ramen topper was like 35 comparatively to the standing figure that was 40. So I ended up getting the standing figure, which I'm super glad. He made me feel a bit better after my tragic convention weekend. And we finally got to Alabasta in the anime, so now we are seeing Ace in the anime, so I'm happy about that too. A ramen topper? So it's this style of figures that they've come out with. I don't know if it's a recent thing. It's essentially just like a little smaller style anime figure that is in a sitting position, and usually what their intended quote unquote use for is to whenever you make like cup noodles or whatever, normally I believe in Japan and in some cases here, instead of, you know, putting your water in the cup ramen and then putting it in the microwave, most people, they'll boil their water and then pour it into the cup noodle and then close the top so it can steam and cook the noodles and stuff. So these ramen toppers sit on top of the cup noodle to keep the top closed and steam your noodles. But they just sit on the edge of shelves for me. Yeah, I think they're pretty cool. Like I said, they just sit on shelves for me, because I don't want to... Did I? I feel like I messed up my words real bad. But yeah, that's what they're used for. I don't use them for that. I just kind of sit them on... Oh, I can actually show you guys. Let me see. Up there, those are my Demon Slayer ramen topper figures that I talked about before. And then there's my new Ace figure. I'm so happy about him. Okay. There we go. I have many nerd shelves. Okay. But I love my Demon Slayer set. I think they're so cute with their little rice balls. Mm-hmm. I think they're pretty cute. I still need to get the Obanai and Mitsuri for that set, and then I will be complete with that little set. Oh, that is crooked as all hell. You let go of your nerd shelf a few years ago. Too much going on. Yeah, I can understand that. It gets a little overwhelming. That's why I became a lot more selective of the things that I buy. Like, don't get me wrong, I still have a shit ton of stuff, but I have definitely narrowed down the stuff that I buy, and I don't buy stuff just because they have it. I buy it if, like, it's like a rare item, or like I don't see stuff for that particular character hardly. Like for Ace, I only ever see like the shitty foam hats that they have for him. I don't ever see like figures or anything. And so when I saw an actual figure, I was like, oh, my boy. I have to. And every couple of years, I kind of go through my figures and I'm like, am I still super attached to this? Do I still have an emotional attachment to this? And if I don't, then I can go and just kind of get rid of it. I sell them, of course. Try to make back some of the stupid amounts of money that I've spent on figures over the course of my life. I did see and want to pick up a buggy pop figure from One Piece, but I forgot. So I didn't end up getting him. So apparently, I didn't want him that bad. The Ace, though, I was like, I saw him, and I was like, I gotta go back to my table. I gotta get money. I, like, ran over there. Of course, it wasn't far. It was, like, 5 feet. But I still didn't, like, bring money with me whenever I went to walk around. So I was like, I gotta get money. I gotta get him now, before I forget. It was 3 shelves, sold it all. Now it's 2 large bookcases, to which there's no room left. Yeah, we have a bunch of bookcases, and Joel actually built quite a few shelves for our house so we could have room for more shit. Like, he built that shelf that all my ramen toppers are sitting on. And he built my coffin shelf, which, don't mind those boxes, he built that coffin shelf for me too. So, he's definitely made a bunch of stuff for our house, so we can have a lot more room for all of our things. The room is a total mess because I haven't put away all my stuff from convention, so the room is a wreck, but you get the idea. Do you just have a whole bunch of, like, books or movies on those shelves that you mentioned? Okay, I did put that on another layer. So we have shelves all over the house. All books have the movies and CDs in a drawer. One shelf is all art books. Top shelf is the Wheel of Time saga. Don't ever... Don't have every book of that yet, nor have you finished the series. That's okay. I have finished very few book series in my life. It takes a lot to really hold my interest. So, I kind of drop out of books pretty frequently. But I like listening to audiobooks every now and again. If I get tired of listening to music or podcasts at work, I'll listen to one of my audiobooks. I need to listen to the Witcher series. Because I have bought, well, I say I bought, I used a bunch of my Audible credits and I got the entire series of The Witcher. So eventually I need to listen to that. A long series. Each book is thick. You think there's 14 of them? The Amazon adaptation is a disgrace to the author and fans. I guess they made a TV series of it and it was trash. Hey Stace, what up? You had a friend in middle school who read the Wheel of Time books, blown away by the thickness of the books. The thickness. Stacy also knows about how adaptations can ruin a book series. Just get her talking about that. What was that? What was that series called, Stace? That they made a movie and they ruined it. It was like the Stephen King books that you liked. It's on Amazon Prime, ruined everything about it. In the first 10 minutes, horrible. Think of the series as the duality of man and woman when they bring to reality? Dark Tower, that's... Don't get you started on the Dark Tower series. Yeah. Yeah, she can definitely relate to you about the whole book adaptation getting ran through the dirt with a movie or TV adaptation. Which is so sad. It really sucks when that happens. Still your favorite book series, though? Yeah. I need to see if they have that on Audible. I bet they do. I might have to give it a listen. I need to listen to The Shining, because I got it on Audible, and then I just haven't listened to it yet. I keep getting distracted with other things. It's all so tiresome. Yeah, it really sucks when stuff like that just gets ruined. It's unfortunate. But Stace, I told them about the con being trash. And about how that vendor was yelling at the con runner at Y2Con. But I also, well, I guess I heard two different viewpoints for Salt Lake. I think that's what it was called. Could have been worse though. Yeah, it could have. We could have not made back any money. So it definitely could have been worse. Could have been better. But it could have been worse. But I heard two different opinions about Salt Lake City FanX. One of my friends that I have been following for a long time, she had a really good experience. But then another person that I follow, she had the complete opposite experience. She had really low sales, didn't make back her table, didn't break even or anything. So I'm like, okay. Not sure how that one was. Gotta be thankful for the money always. Yeah. Thankful that I had that money to finish paying off October's pin club design, and I paid for the hotel for Fan Festival, and I'm gonna pay taxes. So at least I have the money for that. So it could definitely be worse in the grand scheme of things. Apparently, Ron and Yuki and all them, they ran into a pretty gnarly storm on their way home. Well, Yuki was already home because she didn't have a con, but on their way home, apparently there was some pretty gnarly rain. So we fortunately missed out on that. It was a super dry and smooth sailing on our way home. Oh my goodness. Still sleepy. Oh yeah, Stace, you know how I got that that new water bowl for the cats, the new fountain? I got it set up yesterday. And like Moo kind of played with it for a little bit and then she drank out of it cuz the whole sink spout looking situation. And after that kind of left alone. Digit didn't mess with it at all. But after all that, after going through this, like, freaking out because he wasn't drinking out of that bowl, and then Moo wasn't drinking out of that bowl. But when I got home on Sunday, like, the bowl was almost empty, so I was like, okay, well, somebody's drinking out of it. Who the fuck is at our door now? Oh, it's somebody with a clipboard. It's somebody trying to sell something. But yeah, so after all that freaking out, I'm like, okay, well, I guess they're both drinking out of it again. Because I know Moo didn't drink all of that by herself. So I was like, okay, well, you know, that's good that they're drinking out of it. But I had not seen either of them drink any. So I was like, okay, are y'all waiting until, like, the wee hours of the night to drink water? Like, what are you doing? So I was just like, okay, whatever. Set up the new one, went on about my day. This morning, I go into the kitchen to grab some of my migraine meds, and Digit's just drinking away at the old fountain. I'm like, okay, so why are you just now deciding to drink out of it? I don't understand. But I guess it's fine now. I don't know. I don't know why they do the things that they do. Cause fuck you, that's why. Yeah, it's very fuck you energy that comes from cats. They're like, oh, you want us to do this thing? Yeah, no. Not until you least expect it. Just like, please? Dude, I wish I could understand what is going through their little tiny furry brains. Cause it would save me a lot of headache. I wish. But that's okay. We now have two cat water fountains. So now they have twice the amount of water. So they can't go thirsty. Apparently my friend Offie is also live. So Stace, you working on one of your 800 orders that you got? Your mile-long list of to-dos. You're already halfway done? Damn, girl, get it. Did you do a bunch yesterday? Slight exaggeration. She did get, like, a bunch of orders. Both from people at the con and on Facebook and stuff. So she's had plenty to do. You stayed home yesterday and just napped and crocheted? Dude, I wish I could have stayed home yesterday. I was not feeling it. That was weird. Did not want to go to work yesterday. Let's see, turn off that bear. Fuck you guys, I'm going home. Yeah, honestly. Shoot, I didn't even want to go in today. I was like, screw this. This is awful. You don't hardly call in, so it's fine. Yeah. That's good. So what all did you finish already? I know you finished one of the baby bundles, because I saw the little elephant. I bought this wall plugin that's supposed to help with the cat's like anxiety or whatever, since the vet was like, yeah, it's probably stress related with Digit's like water consumption situation. So I was like, okay, well, I bought this thing. It's like, it's supposed to help with cat stress. I was like, okay, my cats are just gonna be high all the time. This is fine. I will say Moo has chilled the fuck out quite a bit. This is like how normally she cries at any door that's closed. She has not been crying at doors lately. And she hasn't been like up Digit's ass nearly as bad. So I think she may have mellowed out, which may in turn help Digit. That wasn't an order. Oh, was it not? I thought it was. You finished the beanie and the two mushroom keychains and almost done with the longhorn? Sick. Yeah, I mean, those things don't take you any time at all. Especially not those little tiny mushrooms. Took you probably, like, what, 5 minutes? Before I started stream, I took photos for the prince's keychains, so I'll be able to add those to my shop later. I was hoping to have those new things dropped on my store today, but just was not feeling up to it. Any other interesting things from the con? There's a really hot guy dressed as Mihawk. That was it. He was one of, like, the professional cosplayers, and on Saturday he was dressed up as McCree from Overwatch, and then on Sunday he was dressed as Mihawk. Stacy and I successfully cosplayed as Power and Makima. That long-ass wig gave me a migraine, but it was fun. I also couldn't see out of my right eye for most of the day because she has, like, a little piece of bangs that covers her eye. So that was eventful. I also ended up having to tie the back of the wig into a ponytail because it kept, like, trying to flow over my shoulder because the wig was too fine. So, trying to think. I already talked about us going to Chili's and having a bitch sesh about the con. I was finally neighbors to my friend Willow. Finally table neighbors with her. Because we always see each other at cons, but we're always, like, hella far from each other. So Stace and I were table neighbors to Willow, which was super fun. Got to see both of my friends named Nikki and Rio. One of my friends named Nikki, she dressed up as, oh shoot, I can't remember his name, but the white-haired vampire guy that everybody's fawning over right now from Baldur's Gate. And I already said I got the Ace figure. Me and Willow did a keychain trade. I think that's pretty much it. Stace, do you remember anything eventful that happened at the con that I have not mentioned? You what now? You got gypped? Is that what you're trying to say? And if that is what you're trying to say, how did you get gypped? How did you get gypped? Trying to cook and type is working. She was trying to pick up a couple of figures for a couple of, I guess they would technically be Dustin's second cousins since they're his cousin's kids. A couple of Dragon Ball Z figures, and they wanted Broly and Frieza, and we looked around the whole con for Frieza. We found a Broly pretty quickly, pretty easily, but we couldn't find anything of Frieza. And finally, she went to go grab the Broly and try one last time to go find a Frieza. It was like, I guess shortly before the end of the con. And she comes back, she's like, I finally found one. I was like, oh, sick, cool. And she shows him to me and I was like, okay, so how much did you pay for it? And she was like, I was like, oh no, how much did you pay for it? Which, it's not a bad looking figure by any means. It's just, it's one of those that I would not have paid as much as she did. It wasn't an exorbitant amount of money, but it was more than that figure was worth, in my opinion. But unfortunately, that is what happens when you buy figures at cons sometimes. This is what happens when you let me go alone. Yeah, next time if you have to buy figures, I'm going with you. Or I will get you to send me photos and I'll tell you yes or no. Or if you should haggle. Yeah. But now you know, anytime they're in that type of a box, do not pay more than like $40. You still haven't told Dustin... That's okay. That one can just be between us. And the guys on stream. Our little secret. It's fine. He doesn't have to know. He just showed up and he said it was cool, but that was it. That's awesome. That's it. That's all he needs. I'm still a little upset that I didn't get that buggy figure, but. Or that buggy pop. That's okay though. I didn't need him that bad. I got my true favorite. And that is all that matters. You're plating food, so if you don't answer for a sec, that's what's happening. Okay. What did you cook? Whenever you get a chance to respond. What do Kiki's shoes look like? They're just little flats, I think. Thank you. Going to bed early? Man, going to bed real early. You must be real sleepy. Well, good night. Thanks for hanging out. I'll probably be streaming tomorrow if you're around, so I'll probably be working on Oni's commission tomorrow. That way I can try to knock that out. Big sleepy. So big sweepy. Ah, working tomorrow. Felt it. Well, have a good night and have a good day at work tomorrow. My hand looks so dumb. Let's see. Okay. What did you make? Yeah, she had to finish plating food. And she just got back. Chicken and shrimp fajitas with beans? Wow. Fancy. Meh, what are you a weirdo that doesn't like chicken or shrimp? There's no meh to that. Homemade fajitas are bomb. In black bean sauce? I've never heard shrimp be cooked in black bean sauce. Meh whores. Never had black bean sauce. I don't feel like I have either. The only time I ever have black beans is when I get nachos at Qdoba, so. You do love black beans, so you'd probably like it. Yeah, you're not super picky about stuff, so I imagine you probably would. There's very few things that you just hate. I mean, I do too. It's just, I I'm a bit more picky and weird about stuff. Food is good. Especially if it's free. If it's free food, best food. Except raw carrots, you'll starve. I love raw carrots. I don't like cooked carrots. Me and Joel are both that way about cooked carrots, not about it. Eat non-cooked carrots all the time, though. I will say the one thing that you're a bit weird about is your crunchy issue. Nothing can be crunchy for Stace unless it is chips. You've tried so many times, even with cooked carrots sometimes, it just gets to you, you can't do it. I think you just don't like carrots, man. I think you just don't like carrots. I think that's the end all there. That's also because they just taste like meat at that point when they're in pot roast. They just absorb so much of the meat flavor that they don't even taste like carrots hardly anymore. You got the vegetables and Panda one time, at Panda one time, and had the carrots left. I was like, I can do this. I hate to go buy it and immediately know. Yeah, I just don't think you like carrots, man. I think I think it's not about cooked versus not cooked. I think you just don't like carrots. Which is fine. You don't have to like carrots. I mean, there's plenty of stuff that I don't like, or Joel doesn't like. His is a much longer list, but still valid. You try so hard to like them, though. You want to like them. That and oatmeal. Oatmeal's hard because oatmeal is a texture thing. Which there will be some days where I will eat oatmeal just fine, not be grossed out by it, but then I'll try to eat it like a week later or even a couple of days later and my body's just like, no. That has the consistency of vomit we don't want. I'm like, oh, okay. This was fine like 2 days ago. Why is it not fine now? Yep, you have to have malt oatmeal. You can't do oatmeal at all. Yeah, it's been a long time since I've had malt oatmeal. I like malt oatmeal. It's pretty good. Pretty tasty. Hollywood writer's strike will end at midnight. Their leadership has accepted the deal with the studios. 148-day strike. They finally did it. That's good. I'm so glad that those greedy mofos finally agreed to the terms. Now maybe we'll get Stranger Things season 5 before all the kids are in their 20s. Maybe. It does really suck that is gonna put them behind so far on stuff. But I'm glad they finally got everything resolved. Oh yeah, speaking of Stranger Things, I decided to discontinue all of my Stranger Things stuff. Because I did one final restock of both Steve and Eddie, because I was like, oh, these, you know, these always do well. Haven't sold hardly any since, so I was just like, you know what, I'm gonna make room for new stuff. And I'm just gonna discontinue all of these and discontinue all of my swordsman pins. So, those are gonna be gone off of my shop pretty soon. So, I'll have room for new stuff. What that new stuff will be, I am not sure just yet, but I do need to work on 2024's Patreon sticker club, or not sticker club, pin club stuff at some point, so that'll be more stuff that I'll have for conventions. And new enamel pins in general. This is a little bit smaller that I can fit more of the broomstick on here. Okay, that looks pretty gnarly right now, but I'll get that fixed up. Mm-hmm. Okay, that looks pretty good. Okay. So I started watching Bungo Stray Dogs again. I say again. It's basically like the first time I've ever watched it, because I think I've only watched like two or three episodes prior to watching it this time. And the first time I watched it, I think was, or the first time I had seen any of it, it was prior to watching Jujutsu Kaisen. So I didn't realize that one of the main characters is voiced by the same guy who voices Gojo. And now I can't not hear Gojo. Think I tweaked my lower back over the weekend or slept wrong or something. Ow. On Palmon. She really does look like Meowth with those little cat ears I gave her. Did not realize that when I drew her. That might be fun to do eventually. Draw either Digimon wearing Pokemon onesies or vice versa. That might be pretty cute. Do a little crossover set. Do the little cat ears. There we go. That's really cute. It's like it's behind this leaf in the front and then in front of the other two leaves behind. Mm-hmm. Actually, the front of the bag should lean further down. There we go. Okay. Okay, I think that should do it for the line art. Missed a spot on the shoulder. And I missed a spot right there. There we go. Missed a spot on the bag. Okay. Oh my god, Digi, you scared the crap out of me. I forgot that you were in here. Hi, Bubba. I forgot you were in here, dude. Hi, baby. What you doing? Thank you. You're so sweet. Okay, now what color? Okay, claws go from purple to green. Oops. Part. You can't see it, but I'm pretty sure it's yellow to orange. Let me see. Hi, babies. What is it? See. Let me look up a picture of Palmon. Okay, yeah, so it's that yellow to orange. There we go. There's Palma. Okay, now these cute little ears. Now the red for the bow. Okay, the color of the shoes, it's like a little orange. I think I'm gonna leave that off, actually. Last survivor of the stream? No, there's still... Nope, I guess Stacy left too, I don't know. She may have fallen asleep or something. That's fine, I'm... about to end anyway. Hi baby. Yeah, we're about to get out of here, don't you worry. Got all the way through the liner, got all the way through the flat colors, so that way the radio, I don't know if I want to. Doesn't mean I can. It wouldn't take long. I'll draw that. I may draw that. If I decide to draw it in, I'll draw it in next time. But yeah, finish the line art, finish the flat colors. So we have Mimi and Palmon as Gigi and Kiki. So I'll probably finish this up tomorrow and then start working on trying to finish up the first part of Oni's commission. And then I will get started on his second commission. So, I'm gonna go ahead and peace out for tonight. I got some other stuff I need to do. I need to finish inventory and stuff. But, alright, it was fun. We got a lot done. So, I will see you guys later. Bye!